This is Tori, and she's a peregrine falcon. And she's been with us now for about 7 years. She was found in Oregon. She was in a field, actually. As you can see, this left wing, it's not complete. She actually had to have it amputated right at the wrist. These birds love to be near open areas where they can hunt, but they like to be up high. Their hunting is not close to the ground. They start out, they're usually on cliff ledges or ledges on skyscrapers, any kind of tall buildings is what they prefer. So when they go to hunt, what they'll do is they'll stand up on the top of this tall building, they'll survey around. As soon as they see their prey, what they'll do is they'll kind of tuck their feathers back, their wings back very closely to their bodies, and then they just dive. They've been clocked at 242 miles per hour, so they're the fastest animal on Earth. As they approach their prey, what they'll do is they'll swoop up, they'll take that huge foot, as you can see here, and they'll form a fist out of it. They take that fist and they bop that bird right on the top of the head, knock it out cold, bird's unconscious. Then they'll swoop around, come back up, grab the bird in their foot, and then they'll fly off with the bird in their talons to their nest where they'll eat it. On the top part of her beak, there's this little projection. It's kind of like a little arrowhead, it reminds you of, and that's called a tomial tooth. When she gets in the nest, she uses the top of that portion of the beak to snap the spinal cord of the bird that she's caught, and that's how they make the final kill. One of the things that is really remarkable is you'll notice in the top of the sear, that band that goes across the top of the beak, that band of skin, you'll notice the two holes. Those are the nares, her nostrils. Within that is this little peg, it's like a spicule. And what happens is, when these birds fly at such high speeds, you have to worry about how in the world can they breathe while they're flying at 242 miles per hour without having their lungs burst. Well, this is a special design of this bird that prevents the air from being so strong. It actually reduces the airflow while they're flying. She also has what looks like a helmet or a hood on her head, that black coloration. And what it is actually is her rendition of sunglasses or sunscreen to try to keep the glare from their eyes while they're traveling at such high speeds and while they're flying after prey. As far as conservation goes, these birds used to be on the endangered species list. It was due to the DDT that was used in the 50s and 60s as a pesticide. And once that was banned, there hasn't been a problem. They've been taken off the endangered species list. But during the time that the ban was on, it was put in place because these birds were not being able to reproduce. The eggshells were too thin due to the pesticide causing problems with the shell. In a lot of cities, they're doing this now where they're actually setting up these video cams so that people can watch what's going on. They can actually see the life cycle of the birds, where they lay eggs, they hatch them, and then they can watch them fledge. So it's pretty exciting.